Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today I have yet another Amazon India haul for you. I do unboxings and Amazon hauls almost every month on this vlog channel and you guys always want more. So usually I do pantry hauls, but if you've been following my channel this August, you realize that I did a lot of shopping for August and I actually split it in two. So the first video had all the food items that I bought. There was a lot of stuff. There were ready-to-eat snacks, there were cooking items. And if you'd like to watch that video in case you missed it, you can by pressing the I in the upper right corner of this screen. This is part two of the August haul. It was supposed to come early in August, but I got a little bit delayed, so sorry about that. This is all household stuff and there is no food here, but there are other things that are like going to be useful for my home and hopefully it will give you guys some ideas too for anything that you might want. There are some cleaning supplies, there are some things that will make organization in the kitchen a little bit easier, and there are a couple of things that are just not kitchen related but I would say generally lifestyle related. Let's just get into the video. So the first few things are a few big bottles that are out here. This is Gentile liquid detergent. So this is obviously for washing clothes. And this is in a buy one get one free pack. So basically you're just buying two at a time. My mom uses Surf Excel Quick Wash, I think, for most of the clothes. The ones that are a little better quality, especially if they're like wool or some kind of delicate fabric, or they're just like nicer clothes, she would use Gentile for it. And the next thing that I have is two bottles of Comfort. This is a fabric softener or a fabric conditioner. So just like you put conditioner for your hair after shampoo, you're supposed to put this in the water after you use the detergent and after you wash the clothes. Something that makes your fabrics really soft, and it's especially good for either your home linens or bath towels. It makes everything like really soft and fluffy. It feels really good. The next cleaning related bottle that I have. Now this is actually one of Amazon India's own brands. They have a lot of their own brand things available. And the best thing about Amazon's brands is the quality matches almost all the other products that are in the market, like the branded ones. Amazon brand may not be as well known, but the quality is just as good and the price is cheaper. Whether they have household stuff, whether there are small electronics, or whether it's just even pulses, I'll buy Amazon's own brand because I know that I'm getting really good quality and I haven't been disappointed till now. So this is supposed to be a disinfectant surface cleaner. You can use these while swabbing the floors of your house. You can use these while like wiping down kitchen counters or your bathroom. Especially on granite and tile, this is really good. And it kills 99.9% germs, it's safe on your hands. And they had a few different fragrances. I actually wanted to purchase lavender because I love lavender, but it was out of stock. So I went with citrus, which would be like my second choice. Citrus smells amazing and it makes your house smell so fresh. I can actually get some of the fragrance right now. And it smells great. This bottle is a good size bottle that's going to last a while. I think this is 2 liters. Wow. The next thing that I have in here is sanitary napkins. Chances are that if you yourself are a woman or you have ladies at home, you do need sanitary napkins. And ever since I was young, my mom has always taught me to be really prepared. So I always have a good stock of napkins at home. Sometimes when I go on vacation, I forget. But that's a different story. I know that some of you ladies have the habit of actually running to the store or sending someone to the store last minute when you get your period. But I think it's a really good idea to always have a stock at home just so you're not caught unaware. So this is something sort of new that I'm trying. It's Stayfree Advanced All Night Ultra Comfort Extra Large. So the pad is really long and it's supposed to be really soft and it has wings. So again, the review sounded like something really nice that I might want to try, and I always prefer longer pads just because there's less chance of any kind of leakage or like staining, anything like that. I'm gonna try this and maybe I'll mention it in a vlog if you guys want to know like if it's good or not. I bought a lot of Scotch-Brite cleaning supplies for the home because I love Scotch-Brite. I feel like they make the best quality stuff. And they are a little bit expensive for sure. But again, I haven't really been disappointed by the things that I've purchased from them. All this stuff I'm holding is Scotch-Brite. These are heavy duty outdoor gloves, but I'm not going to be using this for any heavy duty stuff. I would use it within the house itself. So I already own their kitchen gloves, and I use that if I'm washing utensils. I like their kitchen gloves, but they're really thin. So I decided I would try out these heavy duty gloves just to see if they were thicker. If I was doing like any household cleaning, I just want something stronger. They pretty much have three sizes in all their gloves. I have purchased medium, so usually I would go for a small or medium. One thing that I don't like about their gloves is they have a really weird fragrance, and I don't know what they put on it. It bothers me a little. These are not bad. They are slightly loose, as you can see, like there is space in each finger. If I bought the small size, it would have fit me very perfectly, but it would have also been tight. So this gives me a little room, and I have long fingernails, so my fingernails are not touching the ends, and this feels a lot thicker than their kitchen gloves. It's also got a texture on it, so I assume that means when your gloves are wet, they don't become slippery. There's a little bit of a sort of a fine texture on the gloves. I like them. This is the Scotch-Brite sponge wipe, and this is just again for wiping kitchen counters and stuff if it gets wet, and they absorb a lot of liquid if you have spills or something. There are three sponges in here of different colors. The one in the front's yellow, the one at the back's pink. So my mom has been using these since I was young, and they do a good job, so I purchased some more. This is the Scotch-Brite household scrubber brush. So this is the place that you use to grip the brush, and this is the scrubber at the end. This is not something you would use on all surfaces because the bristles of the brush are really quite thick and coarse. They're kind of rough. So this is something that you will use in places like outdoor areas, maybe on tiles if they've collected dirt, or any place that tends to collect a little extra dirt and it's stained and you need something tough to remove it. This is where you would use this brush. And next I have the Scotch-Brite bathroom scrubber brush. So this is what the bathroom scrubber brush looks like. Again, it's something like really coarse. It's got this rough pad at the end, and this is again supposed to be for like tiled or granite or marble surfaces, and also it's supposed to be for corners. Like bathrooms tend to have a little bit of dirt sometimes just gathered in the corners, so when you're deep cleaning, it's something really useful to scrub out all of the grime. This is another Scotch-Brite item. It is a small squiggy brush. Squiggy or squidgy? I think it's squiggy. This is obviously to clean usually glass surfaces, and you can use this for cleaning windows or even like glass tables and stuff. So I guess I bought this more as a window cleaner, but again, it's useful in the kitchen also if you want to like throw some water into the sink or something. The next item is not from Scotch-Brite. It's actually from Cello brand. Cello has a good line of household cleaning supplies called Cleano. So they have a lot of things under this line. And one of the things that I purchased now is this set of a brush. Ooh, it's so soft. And a dustpan. And what's the cool thing is that you can see that the brush and dustpan kind of interlock together. There's this little wire holding it together, which I can take out. So it's better for storage, and this is good for like just removing a little bit of dust from some area and just cleaning up. I especially need stuff like this because I have three cats. Will you come here? Yeah, come here. This is one of them, and especially around their litter box and all, they make a lot of kachra, so we have to clean that area 2-3 times every day. Something like this comes very much in handy for us. And I tried this similar brush and dustpan from Gala. It really sucked, and I did not like the quality. But this Cello brush and dustpan, I think this is the second one I'm buying. The first one is still in use and it's really good, so I just bought another one because you never know when these things will go out of stock. So if I see something I like, I just buy a little bit of extra stuff and keep it at home. So this is another famous brand that has gone into cleaning supplies, just like Cello. This is from Milton. Cello's cleaning supplies are called Cleano. So Milton's cleaning supplies are called Spot Zero. This is a sink and a dish brush. So this is to be used in your kitchen sink. If you're dealing with some utensils that have a buildup of grime or something and your small scrubbing pad is not doing the trick of cleaning them, you can use this. Also, the handle is very useful in that aspect. And this also works really nicely to clean the sides of your kitchen sink. Oh, this is the other brush I have already from Milton. So I purchased another one. This is my second brush. I've already used the first one. So these are both similar, but a little different. They're both sink brushes, but this one is narrower and smaller. This one has a bigger surface area. I'm not removing this outside plastic right now, but you guys can get an idea of the size of the brush. Two more bottles I have inside this box. The first one is the Laszlo Universal Vinyl and Leather Cleaner. So they market this more as a car seat cleaner. So if you have leather or vinyl seats, you can spray and clean with this. But we don't own a car, but we have leather furniture. So one of our main sofas and one big chair is of leather. It's kind of a pain to keep clean. You really need to have some leather cleaner to make things easier, because you can't just clean it with soap or anything. This is the first time I'm trying Laszlo brand. I was just searching for a leather cleaner on Amazon and I haven't used it yet. So hopefully it'll be good. So the next bottle I have is the shampoo that I use whenever I'm bathing my cats. This is safe for dogs also. And this is from Himalaya, which is a really trusted brand. It's the Arena EP, a shampoo for tick and flea control. My cats don't have any fleas or ticks right now, but when we were fostering street cats and all, one, two times they have gotten, because obviously if you get street animals in, they are going to have ticks on them. And also if your cat or dog gets to roam free and they mingle with other stray dogs or anything, or even if they roam in a garden, there's a very high chance that they can get ticks or fleas from it. This shampoo is really nice because it cleans out the fur. I thought that since this is a flea shampoo, it would not make the cat's fur soft, but it's so nice. So it hasn't got any really harsh killers like a lot of flea shampoos. So I'm really happy with it. I've tried a couple of brands. This is my favorite among the Indian ones. Next, I have a little soap bar here. My mom has always been a big fan of Dove. So if you look here, this is not just regular Dove. This is Baby Dove bathing bar. Dove itself is already gentle. Baby Dove is supposed to be even more gentle and soft. You have really delicate skin. It's really nice to use baby products because they are the most soft and gentle. They don't irritate skin and they're not harsh. So in here I've got two packets. Actually, they were one order only, but it was a set of two. These little clips. Now you might wonder what these clips are. These are just basically, if you open a packet, especially any food packet, whether it's some snacks or some chips, or sometimes even a masala packet if you don't bottle it, how do you keep it shut? So sometimes we would use a rubber band to keep the packet shut, but this is a really efficient way to shut packets like that. So say this is an open packet and you want to shut this. So you just put this clip here and clip it on, and it keeps your packets shut very nicely. So I've never tried clips like these, but I realized this would be something useful to have at home. And they're actually pretty cheap. Next thing that I purchased is this cutlery drainer and organizer. So this is supposed to be to keep your cutlery in after you washed it. So your spoons, forks, and your knives. I have mixed feelings about this. I haven't put it into use. I actually hate the color scheme. I don't like this weird shade of green. But the reason that I bought plastic is because I found that metal tends to rust. Especially when there's moisture, when you put wet spoons and forks in it, it just tends to rust, and sometimes you can't even tell because it's rusting on the inside. Until you check, you can't make out. So I wanted plastic because plastic is non-porous, so it does not rust or degrade in any way with water, and there's very less chance of a plastic item catching any kind of mildew, fungus, or anything like that. It's easier to keep clean. if you put in something else a little wet also, the water will collect over here in this drainage and then you can just pour it out. You can separate the whole thing so it's very easy to keep it more clean and hygienic. It's quite big in size, so a lot of spoons and forks and stuff should fit. And this part that you see over here, this is specially for keeping knives in if you're worried like about the knives not staying in place. So you can just put the knife in like this. The scissors too fat, but you put the blade inside and the handle out. It keeps your knives in a slightly safer manner and it makes it easier for you to access them. I really like the concept behind this and that's why I bought it for the kitchen. The next thing I bought is a pepper grinder or a pepper mill. We tend to only use freshly ground pepper at home. It just gives you a better flavor, but the problem is the pepper grinder we were using was like annoying me because it was majorly plastic and the blade sort of went a little blunt and it was just not working efficiently. This is a glass pepper mill, so that's nice. The capacity is bigger than the one I had, and also turns out here on the outside you can actually adjust the exact coarseness that you want the pepper to be ground. So if you want it to be like a chunky, thicker grind, you can do that. Or if you want it to be more towards powder, there are different dots here. So you can just turn it and indicate exactly how you want your pepper ground. And that I thought it's something very cool. I didn't realize, sorry, I had another cleaning brush from Milton from the Spot Zero line. This is actually really similar to the Scotch-Brite brush, just the shape is different. This is triangular while this is rectangular. The concept is the same and the type of material that they've used also is very similar. So this is supposed to be the rough and tough floor scrubber and it's to clean your tiles, especially the parts that build up any kind of dirt or anything. You wouldn't clean your whole house's tiles with this because it would take a long time. If there are any stubborn stains, then this is to scrub them. The Scotch-Brite one was more expensive and the Milton brush was cheaper, so I kind of bought both of them because I just wanted to compare how they function. The next thing that I purchased is from Solimo. It's one of Amazon's own brands, just like Amazon Basics. It is this set of three water bottles here in three different colors. So you can get sets of three, you can get sets of six. And I saw very good reviews about this. I'm trying to drink more water on a daily basis. I'm trying to get my 1.5 to 2 liters every single day. So these are 1 liter bottles and they look really nice. They have a wide mouth, so it's easy to either pour in a glass or even if you just want to like drink it directly. The fact that I bought three colors is I bought them for like the three people that live at home, my mom, dad and me. So we can each have one bottle of a different color. And it's easier to monitor your water intake that way. This is 1 liter. If you finish the bottle, you know you've had a liter. And this is really good for working people, college people also. Those of you who want to drink more water. I am definitely going to be using this pink one. It looks so nice. And the inside of the bottle, it even has a little silicone gasket here. So that means that even if it's in your work bag or something and the bottle is moving about, no water is going to spill because that silicone gasket will make sure of it. I have another item from Amazon Basics and this is something for my computer. It's the table that I'm currently using as a computer table. It's a little bit low, so sometimes I feel like, you know, my posture is also not good, but because the screen is low, when I'm working on it, I end up like sitting in a bad way, and then obviously that's not good for your back and it's going to cause like fatigue and back pain if you do this for too long. So this is just something to raise the level of your monitor. If you're using a desktop, you can even use this for a laptop. You just keep it on your desk and it raises your monitor. You keep your monitor on this and you can actually just keep some stuff neatly underneath also, so it makes more storage space on your desk. If your desk tends to be cluttered and you need to keep too many things there, then you can keep some things neatly under this. And I bought this silver color because I use an iMac, so I wanted it to kind of match the iMac, which is a lighter shade of silver, but this will look good with it. But if you use any other machine, then the black one might look better, because especially if your computer is black, it looks really smart. So I'm very excited about using this because I think it's going to be something that's going to help me in my everyday life when I'm sitting and working, because I work from home. I spend a lot of time at the computer, especially editing, writing emails and stuff. So this is just going to make me like sit better and be more comfortable. And the very final thing that I have purchased for this Amazon haul is something that I've bought for the kitchen. And this is also something that's going to hopefully make things a little bit more organized and save up some space. This is a corner shelf for your kitchen. Technically, you can even use this in your bathroom. You can hang this. There are these little keyholes on the side, so I can even put this like on the wall over here. Yeah, this is not bad at all. But I actually bought this to place in the corner on the kitchen counter. Things that my mother uses every day, like if she's using sugar, salt, tea powder, anything like that, you can just put it on these two shelves. So it's going to be like easy to access, and again it will actually free up some clutter on the kitchen counter. So this is really good quality stainless steel, and it was a little bit pricey, but I think it's going to be something good. It's even got these little plastic legs at the bottom so that the stainless steel does not scratch anything. And they were available in a few different shapes and sizes, and I think there was even a 3-level one available. I spent too much of time figuring out what is going to be good for us, what is going to be a better shape, a size, and this is the one I settled on when I received it. I think I found it perfect. It has not been put into use as yet, hopefully really soon. And again, I think this is something that would help a lot of kitchens or a lot of spaces. And also the fact that, you know, you don't have to screw it in, you don't have to make holes in your wall, you can just place it there. That is something that's quite good, I think. So that was everything for my August Amazon haul part 2, and I'm going to have a new haul out really soon, maybe at the beginning of October, where I'll show you guys a lot of pantry items. I'm signing off for today. If you enjoyed this haul, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more regular hauls and for daily type of vlogs and anything like that. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them below, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.